with MTV. The B-52's perform live. Plus, we've got a world premiere video from Peter Gabriel. Skinny Memphis rocks the house, and we'll count down your most wanted videos of the day, and lots more. So now, here's your host, Steve Isaac.
Skinny Memphis, our house band, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Hangin with MTV. I'm Steve Isaacs. This is a ritual that we go through every day from 6 to 7, and this is coming to you live. And it's Monday, you know, and we figure, well, it's Monday. It's not the easiest day. It's not the easiest thing to deal with. So we brought you a special present. And right over there, the B-52s are going to perform in the next hour two tunes from their latest record, Good Stuff. How's that for making your Monday just a little bit easier? Plus, we're going to count down the most wanted videos of the day as you called in and voted for them. But right now, we're going to kick things off with something really special. It's a world premiere video from Peter Gabriel. The video is directed by John Downer, who's done a lot of National Geographic videos on insects. And here, he combines insects and some amazing animation that may even outdo Sledgehammer, Peter Gabriel's former groundbreaking video. And this is a video from the upcoming album, Us. It's the world premiere for the first time anywhere. Peter Gabriel's Digging in the Dirt. It was the world premiere of Digging in the Dirt from Peter Gabriel, and you can see it again tonight on MTV at 10 o'clock in the evening and 9 o'clock Central. And Central people, you know who you are. It's okay. Shh, it's okay. Relax. All right. Oh, no, this is an amazing audience. We're going to show you them in a little bit. We got the fashion posse over there. That's Todd Oldham, one of our favorite designers here at MTV. We're chilling out. We have lots to cover here on Hanging with MTV in an hour, so we're going to take a break, come back, kick off the countdown of your most wanted videos of the day, and right after the break, we're going to see the B-52s live right here on Hanging. So see you.
For some reason, they're having me host the MTV Video Music Awards. Mommy, he not look like Garth. Me sad, Mommy. Swing, Mommy. You be there. Maybe I'll be there.
The PB and PB Max doesn't mean penguin black belt. Nope, the PB means peanut butter. Covered in milk chocolate with a hearty crunch in every bite. PB Max, we mean peanut butter.
Last night, Russ Beeler, owner of Lake Edna KFC, opened Hammer's eyes to new popcorn chicken. Delicious, crispy, bite-sized morsels. A whole new way to enjoy the Colonel's chicken.
Come on, Hammer.
The problem was, no one could get him to go on until the last piece was gone. New KFC popcorn chicken. Treat yourself for $1.99, the band just $5.99 in Lake Edna or your neck of the woods.
Open your coat, please. Take that thing out slowly and open it.
You got some kind of device. We have a possible situation.
Just touch the button, sir.
Quietly, please.
It's just
a
car stereo.
Pioneer car stereos offer you a detachable face for the ultimate in security.
You see, it's a detachable face for the car stereo. What's the matter with these people?
So you got rejected by every medical school in the country.
Welcome to med school. In paradise.
Fish Goldman, would you like some?
No, thanks. I'm a cowman. See that guy who's dressed in green?
He's not a man, he's a lover machine. From the creators of Northern Exposure.
I don't take notes.
What, you keep it all in your head?
Uh-huh.
Going to Extremes, tomorrow on ABC. Because a tan is a terrible thing to waste.
Imagine this is your skin. How would you describe it? Normal. Dry, sensitive, oily, oh, rotten. Whatever type of skin you have, we make a Stridex pad for it. Because a smart way to get rid of your pimples and help keep them away is to use something specially made for your type of skin. Stridex. Because you only get one face.
Thank you.
your source for Levi's loose-fitting jeans.
Welcome back to Hangin' with MTV. It's time for some live music from our special guest today performing. Is that you, Modine, from the new record Good Stuff? It's the B-52's!
Half-life. On the bus, to the plane, to the
the B-52's and us here at Hangin' when we come back. Thank you.
Well done, Fred. I'm Steve.
Thank you.
Hi. Well done, Julie. Thanks.
From Warner Brothers and director Cameron Crowe, Singles, a new film about being friends, being lovers, being single. The MTV Singles You Out contest. Win and we'll fly you and a friend to LA for the exclusive premiere party for Singles. You can join Bridget Fonda and Matt Dillon while rocking live to performances by Pearl Jam, Alice in Chains, and special guests. To enter, send a postcard with your name, age, address, and phone number to MTV Singles You Out contest. P.O. Box 1211, Radio City Station, New York, New York, 10101. Enter and it's the single most important party of the year. This MTV contest is brought to you by Levi's Buttonfly 501 Jeans, Brute, and British Knights Athletic Footwear.
When I was small, I thought I would fly.
Check this out. The Scoop. A sporty coupe that's fun to drive. And since you get free service and maintenance, it's also fun to own. So any sleepless nights won't be from worry. The Scoop from Hyundai. Yes, Hyundai. For up to a $750 rebate on Scoop, see your Hyundai dealer now before it's too late.
This is Mel Allen. I've got a special offer on out-of-print collector baseball cards. Now you can own 200 genuine collectible baseball cards for the unbelievable price of $9.95. It's collector's dream come true. Each set contains baseball cards going as far back as 1986 and including Topps, Don Russ, and Upper Deck that are no longer being printed. Over the years, the value of baseball cards has skyrocketed. And while no one can guarantee baseball cards will go up in value, we can guarantee each set will have star, superstar, rookie, and all-star cards. So take it from me, Mel Allen, at this price, these cards could be going, gone. 200 genuine collectible baseball cards, no duplicates, mint condition, only $9.95 each, plus $2.95 postage, limit of 5 per household. So get cracking. Call now to order.
Hangin' with MTV. I'm Steve, and if you just tuned in, you missed a great live performance from the B-52's, but don't worry, they're gonna play another tune from Good Stuff a little later on, and here they are, Fred, Keith, and Keith from the B-52's. Played a tune from Good Stuff, and you're about to play another one. Now, the new record was produced by two of the biggest producers in the business, Don Was from Was Not Was, and Nile Rodgers. How was it making the record this time out?
Fun.
We wanted to use the same producers because we had such good results last time, and each producer has a certain way of doing things, and they really like what we do because they both come from a band background. Mm-hmm. And so we like to bring our songs to a certain point, and then we go to the producers to really add the final touches and to take it beyond where we've taken it, and both Nile and Don seem to do that each time.
Well, this time you didn't record with longtime B-52 Cindy Wilson. Mm-hmm. And how was that, working with the three of you? Who sang on the record in her place? Did you do all the vocal parts?
Yeah, I did all the overdubs. When Cindy left, it kind of left a quandary, because it's like a chemical formula when people write together and we all contribute equally creatively. So we didn't even know what it would be like. But I think when we started writing, we started jamming and started doing things the way we always work. And we developed more of a dialogue between Fred and I instead of the three-way kind of rapid-fire kind mm-hmm. of thing we had. And I wound up doing the overdubs on the vocals. While we were writing, I heard all these harmonies while we were writing. I was mm-hmm. getting real excited about doing harmonies.
So the chemistry wasn't lost. Is no. she out, or is she taking a break, or...
She decided to leave.
Yeah, she's taking a break, I guess. Mm. She said, I've been a B-52 for a third of my life, and I want to do something else for a while.
You know?
No doors were ever shut or anything like that.
But right now, you've got singing in her place Julie Cruz, who's famous for working with David Lynch in some of his film projects and Twin Peaks, the TV show. And how's it working with Julie?
Oh, great. She's great. Oh, she fit right in.
She seems like it.
She enjoys, you know, our music, and she has a great stage presence and a really strong voice, so it really works, and she carries, you know, it's hard to fill Cindy's shoes, but Julie does it, you know, admirably, and she's having to bring her own personality to it, too.
Plus, there was a rumor before we even met her, Pat Irwin, keyboard player, suggested that we tried Julie Cruz, and Fred went to see her in Return to the Forbidden Planet, and he said she can really belt out a song, you know, so, and then all of a sudden it was in the paper, and everyone was telling us she'd join the band, so... before I even met her.
Now, didn't you, wasn't there like a Jerry Brown rally a few months ago, and Kim Basinger sang as like a fourth B-52?
Yeah.
Did that really happen?
Yeah, it really happened. It wasn't a dream.
It seems a little surreal. And so that was just a little, you know, fun project, and she just jumped in.
Met Kim backstage when we did Saturday Night Live with Alec Baldwin, mm-hmm. and actually Keith went to high school with her.
We went to the same high school. Mm-hmm. I remembered her, but she didn't remember me.
Oh. So, speaking of issues, why don't you tell us about some of the altruistic things you've been involved with lately, some of the issues that the B-52s are supporting.
So we have concerts for the environment with us, and there's three issues that we strongly support, and we've chosen to be put on the brochure, which Kate has, and they are.
We've got Sierra Club, which mainly focusing on saving our ancient forests, which are really threatened right now, and the AIDS Resource Center, and they've set up Bailey House in New York City, which is a hospice for people with HIV, who are HIV positive, who are homeless.
Homeless people with the disease, they have somewhere to live, and they have some people to care for them, where otherwise they'd just be left, you know.
And this is a model, so hopefully places like this could be set up throughout the country. And the other thing is Planned Parenthood, and things are obvious there, safe sex, sex, you know, counseling, family planning.
Things that people need to know about and sort of are getting, like, pushed away by, you know, government. The government doesn't really want people to talk about certain things, but we feel that everybody should hear about it and talk about it and keep an open dialogue, because this is a democracy. And
everybody
the only way to
should
do it is to get information and, you know, decide for yourself, not have other people decide for you.
Well said. And one thing that people need to decide on this year is who is going to run the country for the next 4 years. This has got to be, I mean, at least as long as I've been alive, the most confusing political climate I've been in. What would you, for people out there, what take do you have on what's going on politically these days?
Vote.
Yes, everybody has to vote. I'm voting for for Clinton.
George. Ooh, one nation under groove.
Yeah,
yeah,
I'm voting for Clinton. Mm-hmm. Whoever can push the Bush out.
All right. Yeah. And there's only approval from the Hangin with MTV audience, too. Yeah. But make up your own mind and definitely vote.
Yes, make up your own mind and vote for Clinton.
Yeah. Cool. Well, why don't you tell us about the tour? What are the next few dates? Where do you think you're headed next?
Well,
where are you headed next?
We fly to Milwaukee tomorrow, and then the next day we're in Minneapolis. And then we're in Boston, I think it's the 5th, so tomorrow.
We're going to Atlanta and Saratoga.
Lots of Florida.
We're going all
over
America.
Lots of Florida.
We played a lot of the same places we played on the last tour, which was 18 months, so we're hitting the hot spots again.
Yikes. Well, one of the hot spots is going to be right here in a few minutes, so thank you for talking to us. The B-52s. See them live in a little bit. But right now, we're going to check out the third most wanted video of the day. It's Crisscross and Warm It Up.
Cool.
That was crisscross and warm it up. Look at this lovely audience. In at number two for the day on our Most Wanted. And right now, we've got the second Most Wanted video of the day from a record that's been on the Billboard charts for over a year. It's Metallica and Wherever I May Roam.